In this video, we're going to compute the determinant of a matrix using the core definition of the matrix determinant. The matrix that we're going to work with is a 3x3 matrix A, given right here. So this is the matrix that we're going to compute the determinant of. And we're actually going to do it two different times. We're going to compute the determinant of A using what we call cofactor expansion. And we're going to do it expanding about two different things. The first time we're going to expand about the first row, and this is usually the way I think about doing a determinant computation. In part B of the problem, we'll actually do cofactor expansion about the second column. And it's always up to you. You can expand about any row or column that you want when computing the matrix determinant. Sometimes it's convenient to choose a certain row or column that has a lot of zeros, because then lots of terms turn into zero and it's much easier to compute. So being able to do the matrix computation for an arbitrary row or column is definitely something that's good to know. So let's go ahead and just start off by doing it for the first row. So I'm going to write down the matrix, and we're going to expand about the first row. So I'm going to go ahead and draw a line through this first row, just indicating that's the row that we're doing our expansion about. The equation that we're going to implement here to actually compute the determinant is given by this equation right here. It says that I can compute the determinant of the matrix A, that's what I want to compute, by computing a summation of these different terms. Each term has a certain sign, a negative 1 raised to I plus J if I plus J is even. That's negative 1 raised to an even power, which would be a positive number. If the quantity I plus J is odd, that would be negative 1 raised to an odd power, which would be negative 1. So a sign here kind of toggles back and forth. And that sign then multiplies the determinant of the matrix A sub IJ. So this is a submatrix where the ith row and jth column have been removed from the matrix A. And you'll see what that means here as we go along. So let's go ahead and start computing this term. What I've done here is I have blocked out the I equals 1 row, because we're doing cofactor expansion about the first row. And then what I need to do is I need to loop over all columns. So when you expand about a row, you kind of loop over all columns. So this first column here is actually J equals 1. It's the first column. So the first term in this summation right here is going to have I equal to 1 and J equal to 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. A negative 1 raised to 2 is plus 1. So the first term in this summation is going to be a positive term. And it's given by where these intersect. So you can kind of picture the first row lined out and the first column lined out. Where those intersect is at 0, so that's why I have a 0 right here. What's left when I put lines through both the first row and the first column is this submatrix right here, which I have put right here. So this is the submatrix A sub 1, 1. It's the matrix that I get when I remove the first row and first column from matrix A. So that goes right here. I need to compute the determinant of this quantity. The next term in this summation is when J is equal to 2. So I'm going to go to the second column. Now I have 1 plus 2 is 3, so I'm going to have a negative sign on this term. And the actual term that goes right there, again, picture this line, these lines intersecting. They intersect in the first row, second column, the number 4. So I'm going to have minus 4 times the submatrix that is left when I remove the first row and second column. Well, what's left? It's this and this, so that's that matrix right here. So this is the submatrix A sub 1, 2. The submatrix I get when I get rid of row 1 and column 2. And then I just continue my computation. When J is equal to 3, now I have 3 plus 1 is equal to 4, so I have negative 1 raised to a 4. So I'm going to have a positive sign right here, so times whatever this number is right here, because that's where they intersect. So plus times a negative 2 is a negative 2. And then this is the submatrix that I have left when I remove the first row and the third column. So that's how things always work when you expand about a row. Kind of just put a line through the row and then loop over each column. As you do each column, the sign toggles back and forth. We have positive, then negative in this case. And then each determinant here is just the submatrix that's left over when you strike out the row and column that you're working on. Now that we've written it like this, it's pretty easy to do these computations because we have submatrices that are just 2x2, and doing 2x2 determinant computations is pretty easy. So let's just wrap that up. We're going to get 0 here because 0 times this scalar is going to be 0. Right? That's going to be easy. And then minus 4 times 1 times 0 minus 6 times negative 7, so that's going to be 0 plus 42. And then minus 2 times the quantity, 1 times 5 minus 2 times a negative 7, that'll be 5 plus 14. So if we just simplify a little bit, I'm going to get 0 minus 4 times 42 minus 2 times 19. This is equal to a negative 168 minus 38, which is equal to a negative 206. So we have computed the determinant of this matrix. It's equal to a negative 206. We did it by computing cofactor expansion about the first row. Let's go ahead and do it by computing a cofactor expansion about the second column. So I start with my matrix. I'm going to put a line down the second column because that's where I'm going to do my expansion about. Again, the equation that we have to compute is this. It tells us how to write the determinant as a weighted combination of determinants of submatrices. This is J equals 2. I'm expanding about the J equals 2, the second column. So now I just need to go and look at each row. So I'm going to loop over rows now. So when I is equal to 1, up here, I'm going to start off with a term that has a 1 plus 2, which is equal to 3. So a negative 1 raised to 3 is a negative sign. So I'm going to start off by putting a negative sign in front of wherever these lines intersect. Well, they intersect on the 4 there. So if I go ahead and do that, I'm going to start off with a negative 4 times the submatrix that's left. That's this and this that are left. When I go to I equals 2, now I equals 2 and J equals 2, 2 plus 2 is 4, so a negative 1 raised to the 4 is a positive number. So I'm going to have a positive number times wherever these intersect. So I'm going to have 2 times the submatrix that's left. So plus 2 times this submatrix. And then I'm going to go back to a negative sign on this last term because 3 plus 2 is an odd number. So I have a negative 5 times this. Again, these are pretty easy determinants to compute. I'm going to end up with a negative 4 times 0 plus 42 plus 2 times 0 times 0 minus a negative 2 times a negative 7. That is equal to 0 minus 14. Minus 5 times 0 times 6 minus a negative 2 times 1. Well, that's 0 plus 2. If we multiply this out, a negative 4 times 42 is negative 168. 2 times a negative 14 is minus 28. And a negative 5 times 2 is a negative 10. If we add all this up, we get a negative 206 again. Which we should. No matter which row or column you choose to expand about, you should get the exact same number because the matrix determinant is a number. It doesn't change based on how you compute it. So hopefully this example helped you learn how to do a matrix determinant computation, expanding about any arbitrary row that you want. It's pretty straightforward. Once you figure out the starting sign, you just toggle signs back and forth. You just got to keep track of how to compute that initial starting sign. And it's based on I plus J. Whatever row plus column you're currently in gives you the sign that you should start off your computation with.